Welcome to this new episode of Siren Video Bytes, where I provide insider tips and tricks on Siren's most popular features. I'm Davide, a data scientist here at Siren. In this byte, I'm going to show you how easy it is to use the Siren search to find relevant information and highlight connections across your entire data ecosystem. Siren Search is a component of the Siren Investigate platform, which also include the Connect and Report pillars. But for now, let's dive into the search. When we open the Siren Search, we can see a very clean interface with a search bar at the top where we can start typing what we're looking for. And more importantly, the dynamic filters here on the left, which not only allow you to have an overview of what data is available for your investigation, but also to slice through the data by categories using these filters. So, for example, I'm going to create a filter for all the Ford Mustang, for example. And we can see how the Siren data model, in combination with the AI, are creating this single pane of glass where I have not only the data relative to the car, but also the data about the owner, the address with a map, and eventually the LPR data if the car was spotted by some traffic cameras. Now we're going to dive in a more interesting example by searching for a suspect and see what we find in our system. So as I was saying before, for this example, I'm going to search for a suspect. His name is Roger Underwood. We can see that as in the previous example, the system is building up this nice visualization, which are giving me a great overview of this person. So even if these are all disconnected sources, the system is connecting them for me. So I can see that he's involved in 26 cases with the last three cases. I can see that Roger owned two vehicles, and eventually I can see where one of the vehicle was spot. I could click and see the details of this record, but for me it's fine. So I can select my record and I can copy selection to my records. Now, imagine I want to find more. I see here we have more results for Roger Underwood. So, for example, we're going to look at the messages. And as you can see, the visualizations are changing. This is because, of course, now we're talking about messages and not person anymore. So we can see this nice bubble chat visualization. And as well, the system is trying to find to match a sender. So as soon as I find a sender, maybe this is an interesting person, I can have a look at the details, and it looks like, you know, they want to continue their conversation on Telegram. So this is interesting to me. I'm going to copy this selection to my record as well. And now we have already an overview of this person plus some probably suspicious activity. And now what I can do is I can simply create a collection for these results. So I'm just naming this Roger Underwood, and I'm going to create a graph. So now I can see I have this nice collection with my record. And in the next byte, we're going to see how we can share these findings with our colleague and create a report. In today's byte, we learned how to use the Siren search to quickly find and grab results that were relevant for our investigation. If you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and please let me know in the comment what would you want to learn next. Thanks for watching.